sinner par excellence. But today, friends, I'm a saved sinner, and my desires are no longer the same. No longer do I desire to sit down and watch pornography on the television. No longer do I desire to take a load of cocaine or heroin. No longer do I desire those things to get a high, because I find that there's a most high. You see, the problem is, friends, if you come out of the closet, you'll have to go to the chemist. That's the scientific fact. The science is today, friends, that monkeypox is coming on those, primarily, who are monkeying around. Oh, yes, God pronounces judgment on homosexual sin. It's in Romans chapter 1, in verses 23 to verse 27, the judgments of God upon sexual promiscuity. God said he would send judgments in the body, diseases like monkeypox, AIDS, STDs, the judgments of God in human bodies for human
sin. I'm so glad I'm recording this.
God, thank God today there's healing in the blood of Jesus. There's healing through the cross of Christ. God can heal you from your sinful condition. God can heal your sinful heart. And God can give you a new heart. And he'll give you a new start.
It's all right, I'm recording it, so.
Male and a female, that's what God will aim. That's what God's calling you to. God's calling you away from your lifestyle of sin to a lifestyle of pleasing the Son. The Bible says, wash your hands, you filthy sinners. Cleanse your hearts. You know, there's a lot of sanitization going on during COVID. What about sanitizing your hearts? What about sanitizing your sexual desires? Bringing your sex life into line with the Bible. Living a life to please God instead of pleasing yourself. What about just having one sexual partner for life instead of Tom, Dick, and Harry? You know, God's calling you today, friends, to do it God's way. Doing it God's way is the best way. That's why Jesus said, I am the way, the truth, and the life. No one comes to the Father except through me. God wants you today to surrender your sexual ethic to him. To do sex God's way instead of doing it your own way. As I understand it, friends, men are not made to sleep with men. Women are not made to sleep with women. But Jesus himself said that a male and a female should be together. That's in Matthew 19, verse 4. It doesn't work the other way, friends. It leads to venereal disease. It leads to STDs and AIDS. Even monkeypox today, friends. It's primarily because of those who are sleeping together, male and female. That's the science. If you want to go that route, God's calling you today, friends.
Run, boy.
Be righteous before God.
You can't play the game.
No matter what you preach or say,
no matter what you preach or say,
there's no fight for me.
See, you can try and silence the voice of the preacher, but you can't silence your conscience, can you? You've got a guilty conscience. That's why you're angry. That's why you hate God. That's why you're intolerant and unloving, because you're full of hatred and anger against Christ and against his word. But friends, that won't stop us preaching, and it won't stop God sending out his good news of the gospel. The good news of the gospel is today that you can just eat. God will deliver you from your sin. God will deliver you from your homosexual sin, your lesbian sin, whatever type of sin it is today. God can deliver you, and God will deliver you, but you must humble yourself. Instead of being proud about it, be ashamed of it. Shaming us today for endorsing the things that God hates. Shame on someone today for coming out and plugging out the lead of someone preaching the gospel. Shame on you, sir. Shame on you. You're full of anger. You're full of wrath. You're intolerant and hateful towards the Christian community. Shame on you, sir. Shame on you. But God says, repent of your sin and God will forgive you. Yes, there's forgiveness for you today. There's real love for you today. Come to the best lover in Belfast. His name is Jesus. Oh, look at the hatred and the spite in people's hearts today. Full of wrath, full of rage against the preaching of the truth of God. You see, you don't hate me, you hate the truth. And you love the Lamb. But be careful, because for those who love the lie, God is a strong delusion. That's why God says you need to come and just eat. And you just need to eat from Jesus Christ and his word. Just eat some good food here today. Here we have someone from Just Eat giving good counsel, or trying to give counsel to someone preaching the Bible. I think you should make your delivery, sir, and make your delivery swiftly and quickly instead
of
bringing out your abuse and your intolerance against the preachers of the gospel. gospel. The word of God today says, friends, that anger and rage and wrath are not from the Lord.
We're getting there.